Okay, guys, so we have got two absolutely fantastic teams here for you in a Division 1 match, which is the James Bakers against CoB Misclick. Now, James Baker, famously from Dignitas, has been in touch supporting the James Baker team. I think he's in some way managing them, and it's a bit of a celebrity team. Caldor's been all over them. There's been a lot of attention. So this is going to be a good game to watch. Give us a minute to sort... Oh, yeah, that's the thing. Everyone in the team is also called James Baker. Official.
What?
Official. They're not really, but like every time they've all met James Baker and they all introduced themselves to him as James Baker.
I'm going to go with CoB as well because that's what they've done in the draft.
No, CoB, it's Misclick because there's like four CoB teams.
But we're watching one. Can I not just go CoB?
CoB hyphen Misclick. Go for it. Come on now.
There we go. CoB.
God damn.
I made the executive decision.
Right, you did the right decision, I believe. Okay.
Nice one. So that is not a murky as well.
So is that not a murky?
That is a Ragnaros. If you just joined us.
Can you cover everything while I sort all this out?
Yeah, boy. That is a Ragnaros pick. I thought it was a murky earlier, but it definitely wasn't. I am now searching for the draft, but I'll just look at it on your screen. And picked up on the side of James Baker, you got a Diablo first pick, which is not the solo tank because they have now gone with Artanis to back up and displace some fools. Tychus to chunk down the anybody in the team that oversteps their mark with a Aureole to keep him topped up on health. And on the side of CoB Misclick, you've got the Rag because it's not a marquee. Rhaegar with probably his Bloodlust, Vala as the damage, Falstad joining the party with his global mobility, and Johanna, the solo tank because she's just that good.
She is pretty good. I do like Johanna quite a lot.
Johanna.
Or would you say Johanna?
I wouldn't.
No, it would be Johanna, wouldn't it? Johanna. Oh. The James Baker mob.
What, so you got Flying Bear on the Tychus, Aureole on the Majete, Lei Ming on Arunis, Artanis on Bread Bucket, and Diablo on Cosmo Boss.
Right, other team.
Dodgy scroll.
Dodgy scroll, thanks very much. Oh yeah. Ragnaros, Gwels, Vala, Tappy that, Prog. Rhaegar is being played by Summer, and Johanna is being played by Shy, and Balabub is Falstad. Balabub, of course, a very popular guy on the chat here at Heroes Lounge. We see him around quite a bit. Okay, so they're going for the 5-on-5 skirmish in mid lane right now. Ming's, of course, got the Aureole crown on her, providing hope for the damage she's doing out. Ragnaros is early. Wow, what a swap. Early and going off the lane himself. He looks like it's going to be a Raggy v Artanis solo lane. What do you think the outcome of that will be, Josh?
I've no idea. But the is that Master Ragnaros skin as well?
What could be?
Doesn't look really normal. But I think he was just showing him. He was like, "Hey, I got swaps here for you, boy." Just to say, like, he knew that there was no backup. He was just like, "Enjoy that."
That's it.
But
that's
it. So what's it look like? They're doing 2-3-3 bottom lane and
I was expecting here was a 4-man rotation bottom and mid. It doesn't look like we're going to be seeing that. Looks like they're going to be doing and they've answered it perfectly, by the way. Perfect synergy from both teams, where Tychus immediately ran off to compete against Falstad solo lane and mid, and the same for Ragnaros in top lane. Let's get a look at those starting talents there, Gibroni. What we got?
We got some good talents. I don't know what... I've never played Ragnaros. I do not own him because I don't have enough gold. So
that
know
looks
what
like
that
he's
one.
Going for the Q build. Often disputed. I personally quite like the Blast Wave build, where you all go for the Blast Wave. But the most obvious build to go for is the Q build, because it's easy to guarantee damage with. Whereas there is an element of skill required in the other two accepted builds for Ragnaros. So I think in this level, against a very competent opponent, that's what they've decided to do here. Okay, so Ragnaros is going to interrupt down there, and they're all fighting for this bottom one.
Knowing that Falstad can just fly in like that, and they have a 4v4, and the bottom lane. Artanis did manage to get the thing off, and Vala fell. Well, Joanna is incredibly low. That's two on the side, James Baker. But that doesn't mean the game's over.
No.
The betting is, though.
The betting is over. You can no longer bet on this match. What an escape there. Barrel roll through the wall, and he's out. Ming doing what she does best in getting siege damage into the towers there. Ragnaros still in top lane, competing a solo lane against Artanis. It's pretty much a dead even stalemate there. Jabroni, can you press a message about that?
Sorry, I can't see the moon now. But Ragnaros is away to fall with his...
There must be a button on the side. Or something. That is brilliant. Oh my god. Seconds. Oh my god. Right, hold on. Ah, there we go.
So, we didn't miss much. Just Ragnaros that was killed and now get chucked down by...
Oh, what a dodge by Ming's orb there. That would have guaranteed James Baker the altar in this phase had Ragnaros been hit by that orb and that. It's just as simple as that. Falstad's in top lane here. Now, he's staying up there to confirm the soak, giving them enough time to then fly down when required, which he's doing now.
He could have stayed a little longer, but that would...
I don't know, I feel like that was about the perfect
way
time.
Way safer getting in early, just in case. But Orion managed to cap it.
There was really no dispute there, was there?
Poor Falstad, using his flight.
Okay,
so what were we looking at on the level 7 talent, sorry? I wasn't paying attention.
So, more evidence that Ragnaros is going for the Q build. Oh, they're going to steal. James Baker being very aggressive here, and it pays off. CoB Misclick looking to punish them for doing so, and failing, orb straight through the wall, just misses Johanna.
Is Ragnaros down again? Falstad.
You know, it's been really difficult for Ming to land some of these orbs. CoB Misclick have been excellent in their anticipation of where she's firing. James Baker doing what they should be here in taking their camp, now that they've successfully mitigated the enemy having one. So Falstad's rotated out on behalf of CoB Misclick to take Ragnaros' solo laning. I think this is possibly the right answer, because Ragnaros wasn't getting enough work done up there.
And it's the furthest away from... Well, it was the furthest away from a lot of the action, so it meant he could stay and soak a little longer and then join the party.
So, someone was asking who the captain of James Baker is. It's currently Flying Bear. He's taken the position away from Alchemy Blue. They're doing really well. I've been watching these guys train over the last... couple of weeks and keeping in touch with them, and they've been a very well organized team that have been coordinating well together, and I think it's really showing here. Okay, so we're at the next altar phase. There's two coming up in mid and bottom. Falstad is still top, had some flying down now.
Just before they could get their level 10s, but now it's been picked up and they are able to stop the channeling of the mid one. Bot has been picked up by Tychus. That's an extra 5 shots, not just 4.
Okay. Having an Odin in play here is a lot of damage. Ragnaros going down.
Is down. He got flipped into. He was.
Now the thing is, Ragnaros's molten core ability is actually not effective on this map at all. To the point where I don't think I would take him, because Ragnaros can use his molten core trait on any tower that you own, any fort or keep that you own. If you destroy an enemy fort or keep, you can then cast it on that, but it needs to be rubble. But there are no forts or keeps on this map that are rubble. When you destroy an enemy fort or keep, it becomes yours. So Ragnaros couldn't actually cast his Molten Core on any of these. So at the moment, he's only got two locations on the map he can cast Molten Core. One here, and one at top. He just missed a Vala, get killed there. James Baker rotating to top, take the sappers, which they're going to use to push down the top lane. I think possibly to actually take the fort rather than the towers.
I think they would like, yeah, they'd like to get that towers. they'd like to get the towers chunked down. Yeah, and they have. So everything should hit the fort, and now they have no walls, and it'll be an easier pickup late game if they want to. It also means Falstad has to stay back and make sure he's had to use a gust to disengage that. That's how much he values these sappers.
That's incredible.
How much he values his keep, fort?
Fort, yeah. Fort. Actually, on this map, I think they're forts to begin with, but then, you know, when it says towers are upgrading, that's when they become keeps.
Knowledge.
There you go. Knowledge. Scotty the
so
knowledge.
So, what do
Halloween,
we think?
That's me.
Should the Murky have been picked up instead of Rag? Just because of your spiel about the...
Well, yeah, I don't value Ragnaros on this map. You can't use his trait unless you are taking all the forts. If you're planning on taking their keeps, then you can use it there, but...
So it's possible that the James Bakers are going to look to invade here because they know that there is no chance of getting to level 13 on the side of CoB. And that's exactly what they've done. They've thrown their ults from Arcanus and Diablo's.
Rhaegar's knocked off Bloodlust. Molten Core activated. Fantastic. Ragnaros going to get some work done here, I think. James Bakers know that he's a threat and are pulling off. They are just at the rim of his range. I don't think we can go much further with Ragnaros' explosions.
Falstad did manage to cap during that as well. Okay. But Artanis had peeled off and capped his own one. So
I feel that's just kept him in the game. Just.
A lot of cooldown burned.
For those of you new viewers that are watching, this Division 1 playoff, absolutely fantastic match between James Baker and CoB Misclick. I apologise about the state of my voice. Having a little bit of difficulty there.
What have you been doing?
I've not been doing anything.
What have you been doing to hurt your throat?
I haven't been doing anything to hurt my throat, but thanks for that very much, Jabroni. I've just got a sore
throat from?
Yeah, from being ill.
Oh.
That's why. There you go. Alright, so James Baker take the sappers yet again, proving their aggression. They are dominant on this map, which is surprising considering they've only got a level lead. You wouldn't normal division, well, I don't know, normal teams, if that's such a thing, wouldn't be able to be this aggressive with only one level lead. You could be this aggressive with like a 3-level lead. Falstad pushing down top tower,
and James Baker are looking to answer that. They're all going up, or
yeah. Oh, he was looking for the swap.
He was going to ruin Falstad's day. I think anybody else but Falstad probably would have been amazing if they caught that, but Falstad would have...
He would have spooched away with a barrel roll.
Yeah, tasty, tasty spooch. And now three altos are out.
All right, so looks like they're committing three people to bottom. No, they're all running up to top.
They want to stop this, but it's fallen.
Now, someone in the chat said, Arkash, you can take Rag to delay altars with the range of the Molten Core, but I don't like it either. That's exactly my point. Now, for example, what they did to defend this altar last game, they can't do now. You can't use Molten Core.
So, the blinds have come down.
Vala's down.
Vala's dead. Joanna is going to die too, because she did not have her D. The apocalypse is catching Falstad. And now Ragnaros has fallen, while Rhaegar cannot do anything. he's going to try and go bottom, sneak bottom, but it is not going to happen, and that could be games. It probably, yeah, it's game.
What am I saying? Could be.
If they get that, yeah, that's another five.
That was an incredible decision.
Wow. There you go. Now it's just for pride. Oh, and they got him as well. It's possible, having lost their first game in this series, that they're now going to play a map that is to their strength as a team and play a composition that they have trained with and see what's going on. However, I do have it on a good authority that CoB Misclick have got two subs playing on their team tonight. So these might be players that they don't have perfect synergy with. So we'll just see. We'll just see what happens.
So the first ban is the hacker, obviously, because you can keep him like top lane, bottom lane, soak in the XP, and then just burrow in. So they just want to remove that. And then a Thrall, because you don't want to be stood fighting in a shrine and Thrall run in, throw down his earthquake, and everyone just craps their pants.
I would, you know, Zul is a famously powerful hero on this map for split pushing, and if he chooses to come into the altar, his cursed strikes are an AoE destruction for minions.
Mm-hmm.
Another one is the Phoenix off of Kael'thas. So I'd be interested to see if either. Oh, and Lightning Bond on Rhaegar. The first talent, Lightning Bond. Take out minions left, right, and centre.
That is how it goes.
These are the obvious strategies that are overutilised on this map. So let's see if either of these teams try that.
So the first pick, Diablo again.
Diablo's great because he can get straight into the fight through the wall using Shadow Charge.
He did a lot of good in the last game for the Jinx.
He does a lot of good.
Well, he didn't die once. He got nearly got the most assists. Nearly. But he didn't die once and he soaked a lot of damage.
How much damage indeed?
He soaked 38 for a relatively short game because Joanna only did 53, but that was with two deaths and he didn't die once, which means more if you do the math. Then you get Tychus and Malfiorian, so they're picking up. I think they banned Tychus last game, didn't they?
We've seen Tychus banned in the previous series before we casted this event. So
I thought CoB had banned Tychus in the first map. The brain's mush, I think it was.
Yep.
And then the mouth, because the roots are awesome. And you can do, can you not talent into doing quite a lot of minion damage?
Well, if you take Odin and then like nuclear weapon and stuff like that. However, our team recently discussed how, there you go, Rhaegar, Lightning Bond. So there, James Baker are going the traditional anti-minion solution.
Tychus definitely wasn't banned in the last game because he was played by James Baker. not by Flying Bear.
There you go. So he was actually played by the captain of James Baker.
There you go.
So that would suggest that CoB Misclick taking him as a first pick is a target at strike against James Baker. They've done that to deny their captain using him. Surely that's what's happened there.
Has anybody seen this chat?
Sorry, keep your mind on the cast.
Okay, right, so...
sorry, there is just filthy conversations going on another screen here, and we're denying it to focus on the KT pick, which, yeah, again, like I say, you take Phoenix, you throw that ring into the minions along with Lightning Bond. James Baker are avoiding the team fight in favour of trying to get the objective here. At least that's what it looks like. Would you agree?
Yes.
There we go.
I was reading the Twitch chat, sorry.
Okay.
I can't do two things.
The Twitch chat should say that they have 3.5 minutes to place bets.
And
currently,
it's all on the side of James Baker. 700 for the James Bakers.
Place bet now!
Versus 100 for a little lonely 100. So that's an 80% to 20% split for anybody at home who likes math.
Can I bet more?
You can probably bet on the same team.
Let me try betting more then. I'm waiting to see what they're going to pick here, because CoB Misclick have used nearly their entire time pool already. Second ban was Kerrigan there. Kerrigan with Maelstrom would have been an interesting kind of...
And she can just be left to queue on to each of the minions while the rest of the boys stick to it, stick to lane and just fend off the enemy team. So quite a late ban, but maybe they just didn't want to risk it. Does that autofocus? Or does that just look like... I don't know what autofocus is.
Oh, looks good. Artanis coming in from CoB Misclick. They are going to be looking to swap people out, put them into the roots, and then let Tychus minigun them down.
Oh.
Now, what I'll be interested to see is if they take another second ranged DPS.
They're going Sylvanas for the push with the Punisher. They're hovering over it anyway. I think they're going to have to because they've only got 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds.
They're going to go for it.
Oh,
what?
They switched to Rainer.
Oh, the Dukes. I like
See,
it.
I don't remember Rainer being played.
James
at
Baker
all.
Just got out-memed. That is what just happened there, folks. Oh, my God. The Rainer jumps in, literally, at the last second and denies Sylvanas. So, Hyperion's now allowed. They can throw that straight over the top. Artanis drops his silence, the blinds. But the thing is, blinds isn't effective against a Kael'thas.
Isn't effective against a Kael'thas because?
Because it's ability damage.
So, is there a way to see Wayne's win white over the last...
Well, it would have to be like the last 2 days to be
day.
Relative.
Day.
You can do maybe last 24 hours on the Hotlog website, but I don't know. I don't know if that's really... Because the thing is, Rainer as a hero in the hands of Hero League from bronze to low silver isn't really a true reflection of his worth in a Division 1 top 10 game with like near enough celebrity status. This that's not an effective comparison.
Yes, Quandary, this is after the Rainer bug fix, but I maybe they know something we don't know and there is another bug or something, but this is the second time we've seen him tonight.
Mm-hmm.
And the first time I've seen him in ages since the bug.
Yeah. We've not seen him for like a long time and now he's back and it's good.
Wins by, I don't know. If
Sardonic saying you filter by latest patch on Hotlogs, and that'll tell you Rainer's 24-hour patch status.
Yeah, you can filter by Master, Diamond, and Plat as well.
Yeah, I think that's a relatively recent addition as well. ETC's coming in as their primary tank.
He is. So you got, who you got on the left, who you got on the right?
We've got James Baker on the left, and on the right we've got CoB Misclick. But Artanis is doing something there, that's good, but that's way better. Look
that's
at James Baker
skin. While Rhaegar was dancing on his back, two legs, everyone was spinning.
Tappy the Frog, he was trying, but largely I think CoB Misclick's Artanis was the dancer.
So what are we looking at for level 1 talent? Halloween's. Artanis still hasn't picked. He was the one I was wanting to see as well. And he's still not picked. He's like, he's doing it on purpose.
Is he going to go amateur opponent or what's he going to do? Yeah.
So what are we seeing for the Zarya level 1? Is that the particle grenade?
Zarya level 1 has been demolitions expert.
So she's building for that for a bit more damage in the play then.
So both teams going for their 5-man skirmish, except Artanis, top lane. So I guess 4-man versus 5-man, and then Artanis. And Chen has come up to answer that. So they tried to get an early experience lead, but I don't think it's going to pay off, because they didn't really miss any minions. 4-man rotation, it looks like. They're doing it proper.
Diablo just had to stand there and take it. And response nearly.
CoB, are you losing him?
Ruined.
Oh, played well done. Well done. Malfurion makes it out by the lick of his heel.
Oh, lick of his heel. That skin is actually really good on ETC. That's cool.
It's so wicked, isn't it?
The keytar on the back. Yeah, Noblesse. There you go. Cheers, Arkash. Noblesse likes the country skin. Is he MVP Black or is he...
Ballistics.
Ballistics. I think he's Ballistics, is he?
Both teams very close on experience at this point. No kills. It's a very even game at this point.
So... Tasty. Tasty.
Okay, I think we're going to go for the...
That ETC is getting absolutely chunked down and he's fallen just before, which is exactly what you don't need.
That's difficult. However, the first objective always takes an age. If you didn't pick an entire team composition based around winning the objective, James Baker have a huge advantage here. Lightning Bond. Where is it? There you go. Casting Lightning Shield on an ally also casts one on you.
So the CoB boys have just completely given up on this. They want to soak top and they want to...
No, they're coming in. They're coming in.
They're starting to now, yeah.
They've got a pincer movement. Remember, it does take an age to get this objective. But, like I say, yeah, they have basically picked around being able to kill those minions. Alright, ECT.
ETC. Arcanus does a swap to get in there, but Chen just jumps on him and just body blocks him to... He's near death, but
he's doing his job right. That's what a tank should do, make them focus you.
Artemis.
Like, we named our team about focusing me, and people still chose not to do it.
Yeah, you feed anyway.
He's Ballistics, by the way.
Ballistics.
Noblesse is Ballistics, and he wore it into your LT. Oh, right, jumps over. That's what you want the Punisher to do. Artana still not refusing. He's still refusing to give up that soak in top lane, so he's went up there to keep the soak up. Punisher's down. They didn't get the fort though. They didn't get the fort, and that's very good news.
I don't think you'd get the fort on your first Punisher unless you were absolutely steamrolling it and maybe had a Sylvanas. But yeah, getting the wall is what they needed. Getting the sippy as well, as you call it.
Sippy
also
cup.
Good.
See there the Chen, highest soaker of experience on the James Baker.
And Artanis just beating him now. Nope, now it's caught up and now it's equal. There you go.
Well, they are solo laning
check
together
for,
so
for stats calling.
Stat calling OP.
How's
here by Gibrone at Heroes League?
Azaria doing with her level 1 talent? BT dubs. About a third of the way. Over a third of the way.
For those of you just tuning in, this is Hero League. Heroes Lounge. This is Heroes
and
Lounge.
They're not playing Hero League. They're not playing Team League. They're
not
playing a custom game.
This is the first division match between James Baker and CoB Misclick. And the stakes are high. These are two very well polished, well orchestrated and designed teams. But I just called it Hero League.
And level
7
has been picked up by both teams, which will be very good because it means less of a snowball.
Now there's been a lane rotation here. You'll notice that Artanis has left top lane and they've instead put Tychus up, who is designed around taking a tank down. I think that was a wise move.
Mm-hmm.
You think that's good?
I think they were aware that he just wasn't getting any work done against the Chen, so they just rightly so.
His name's Chen, just for the record.
And this is where the Dahaka, who was banned, would come into play, because he could sit where Rainer is for an extra long period of time.
Yeah, Balabub needs to get moving.
Jumping.
I don't know what Balabub's doing down there.
He's trying to get level 8, I think, but...
Well, it's now led to a kill.
Yeah, it doesn't help when that happens, because all your soaking goes out the window. Window soak, if you will.
Soaking windows are closed. Because the weather is that bad. It's raining. It is raining feed and memes. Here in Heroes Lounge in Division 1.
So the boys from CoB have given up on the shrine and thought, let's just push down the wall mid in response to this while Rainer soaks bottom. But it's left Shen, if you will.
It's Chen. It's never, if you will.
To do the lane on his own, and they lose 4 at top. So now this Punisher has a straight walk down memory lane.
That memory lane is also going to be their keep. And it's going to be brutal, and I think they've now just realised that. They've realised this fort is not worth... Aye, so ETC is Hearthin. This is brutal.
That was
this
very
could be,
good value.
This is 6 minutes into the game. And that they've got, let's see what Punisher, if it is, if it's, oh, it's Frozen, right, it's anti-hero.
That was a very nice, I think it was just like, okay, they want to push our wall.
They've got ultimates. They need to get that level 10 right now if they've got a hope of not losing the game right now. That Raynor needs to get out of, he needs to hearth. Is he hearthing? I need to check. Right, he is, that's good. Okay, they're coming up, let's see what happens here.
And now the tower's gone down, the Punisher is nearly 100%, 95%. And they can just follow it in and just focus on the keep, and that would be a 6-7 minute keep, which would be crazy good.
They still haven't got level 10,
so they're just having to dance around, poking away. Rainer's just shooting, and
can they get 10? level 10
level they 10
to, they need it so bad. If they, right, now they can counter attack.
There we go. But James Baker is nowhere to be seen, he's bailed.
The Captain Flying Bear is keep holding their rear line as they escape. What a game. What a game.
So what do you think they're moving to now? Bottom camp? Any
the Hyperion
camp?
I want to see the worth of Hyperion now.
It may be a different game. Now they have the globals from ETC. He did spooge it and didn't hit anybody.
No, he caught Flying Bear. He did get 25% of Flying Bear there.
And Chen's bottom, KT is now rotating up. But that was five people, one alt spooged on the side of each team. But the cooldown for Azaria's is a lot lower.
So there goes one spooge from both teams.
And Raynor is having to take out the cannons? Not cannons, the, whatever you call them.
Siege
catapults. Raynor was having to stop the catapults, which they will now have to do.
Nera from Nera Gaming, one of the other casters here at Heroes Lounge, he calls the catapults Winions. And I think that's quite a funny name for them. The Draken Laser Drill dropped down in this team fight.
Rhaegar was body blocked by everybody, even his team it looked like, and he is
He's suffering for it. Yep, the expulsions, Graviton Pulse. Graviton Pulse? Expulsion zone.
Even with that loss, it's still 4v4. Diablo is
the Draken laser drills there. They've also got their fort to help defend. It's still in favour of the CoB Misclick in that team fight. That was good.
Raynor managing to clear.
Chen's claiming lag there. And Flying Bear is immediately caught in excuses. His own team isn't having any of it. Which is excellent. That's good sportsmanship right there.
Yeah, very well done.
Good sportsmanship right there. I like that. I like to see that sort of thing. It's deece. Okay, so rather than going for the objective straight away, they've went for the Bruiser camp to help push pressure on the top lane, which is a wise move, considering there is a lack of keep there to defend against it.
And it's still early. I mean, that's brutal.
It's still so very early, isn't it? That's the thing. It's 9.5 minutes into the game. This is astonishing. To have so much pressure. It's the dominance and aggression levels of James Baker is what I primarily am noting and seeing here, is that they're not giving their enemies an inch. If there's any wiggle room, they're soaking it up, you know? Tappy the Prog coming down here, he's waiting for his team. Balabub's coming in. The Hyperion set, let's see this go into action here.
But with no engage, they've just moved out. They've just moved away. They're just going to wait for the Hyperion to finish, and then they're just going to walk back in.
So they've soaked up some minions there, but it's enough to give them breathing space in terms of who's going to win this objective first.
About half now, yeah, they're getting there.
But the thing is, their tank is in bottom lane. What's he doing down there? Why is ETC down at the bottom fort?
He was obviously trying to get 13 and then
stage dive
in, but he didn't have it.
Yeah, no, but that's irrelevant. They needed to.
He didn't. Yeah, there was no. I think they were hoping to get 13 just before it, so he could stage dive in. But 13 came just too late. Chen, whatever.
Oh, it's Chen, God, man.
I hate this.
ETC.
ETC. ECT. Anything you want.
Just call them whatever. Right, he could stage dive now. Still not, he's running up.
So Bread Bucket was just sitting there soaking shots from Raynor, drinking them, and he just was getting no value while everyone else on the team was able to just wreck their fort. And the keep, the stage dive comes in, it's quite a few, but then was that engaged from Diablo? That was
Flying Bear's taking an incredible amount of damage from the Draken laser drill. Are they going to counter-attack here? I'd love them to counter-attack. I'd love CoB Misclick to run in on this.
But Flying Bear will have the grenades to knock them off the
off their bikes and things. Yeah, that's all right, but then they could catch him. ETC, he's pulling back. They're going for the bruiser camp here. Okay, well, what I am glad to see here is that CoB Misclick aren't exactly conceding defeat. They are pushing this to the limit.
Yeah.
And despite some questionable lane choices at times, they are still trying to pull back.
And they're still... Look at that, level 14 to level 14.
Yeah, the experience levels are very close.
The keep is still standing. I mean, it's still... I know they have to protect the top lane, but they've done that with the camp. They're not out of this game. A good team fight.
Balabub has been an amazing experience soaker for them, for the CoB Misclick team. He's done a good job on keeping the soak up, which is as you described, they're kept them on par level for level.
And if they start winning fights and they start taking the forts down on the side of the blue team, they're going to just start racking.
Like we've seen before, games can change very quickly late game, and this could be this.
I do like that zoning and keep Phoenix there just to make sure that there's even more pressure on the mid now as everyone moves top to start the shrine. So that was decent. I know it's got a 40-second, it's still on cooldown for 40 seconds, but it means that they will have to keep watching and keep an eye out for the Winions, as you call them.
That's what Nera calls them.
Very well done. Deece.
We're about to get another talent come up here at level 16, so I'll bring the screen up for that.
So it's all 5v5 now. Nobody is soaking lane, but...
I feel this is it. This is it. Because they're basically on the same talent tier here. They are on the same talent tier for at least another couple of seconds. This is it. Make it or break it.
James Baker has pushed the lane out so hard that it's difficult for them to get their level 16 talent, but
that's excellent push from CoB here. Got to say, it's managed to zone them straight into their base.
Yeah, a really good time to fight because they're so close to 16. There you go, look, one minion and they got level 16, and they didn't have that the entire fight there. While cooldown after cooldown was burned up.
Artanis has just joined them. Where was he?
Phoenix is back up, Apocalypse is back up, and in 5 seconds, Zarya's got hers, but on the side of CoB. It's a long wait before they get anything.
Well, they've still got Twilight, Nightmare, Dream, whatever it is. So, they've got the sleep affected ultimate by Malfurion, which they could throw in and it would silence KT.
Arunis would have been deleted there, I think, but he was missed by Artanis. And now...
If they get kills here...
Is it going to come out, is it? No.
Twilight, Nightmare, Twilight, Dream, they've got to throw it, come on! Why are they not throwing it? Malf!
Oh my god.
Put it out, Malf!
3 down on the side of CoB. 4 down now with Tychius fallen.
Malf
is the only one alive.
Is
he going to get away?
Threw his ult. Throw your ultimate now! Throw your ultimate now! Just get the kill! Oh! That was at least a minute too late. Why did Summer not throw his ult? He held it.
There's a 97% Punisher wailing on the core as well, with Winions not at the core for the top lane, but 3 of them mid lane.
That's such a shame. Do you know, I'm not being funny, but Malfurion needed to throw that Twilight Dream out right near enough the middle, if not beginning of that fight, to create an opening. Yeah, I mean,